Returning into the realm of Mega Man 4, it's time to take on some Froggy! The realm of chaos enters the land of the Toad. I say nay to your foolish ways, and I just retreat. Be careful when you do jumps in this area. The rain causes you to slip around a little bit. And if you don't push anything, we'll push you back. Another one-up! This game seems to really want me to die now! Not on my watch! I say nay to your foolish ways. Take that, you mice. Take that, gelatin. Take that, more mice. Take that, more gelatin and more mice. I say nay to your foolishness. Mid-boss, snail thingy. Shoot it in the eyes when it's open. Avoid its two attacks of either throwing a bomb or throwing its eyes. Fool. No one can stand against Mega Man! Rematch against the snail boss thingy. Be careful, now there's two spots where you can fall to your doom. Definitely not cool. Cautious. Falling is not fun. Spikes hurt a lot to the face. Luckily, that's it for Toadman stage. Toadman, like Heatman, is a very simple boss in that if you continue to attack him, he will not once use his rain flush. Which gives you two options. You're a stupid toad, aren't you, Toad Man? Wow, this is kind of boring and anticlimactic. Do something! You don't really want him to use Rain Flush, as Rain Flush will hit you no matter where you are on screen. Which kinda sucks. Taste the death. Awesome sauce. Upon defeating Toad Man, you acquire the Rain Flush. As well as a nifty new gadget for Rush, the Rush Marine Adapter. Next up, the master of all things bright, Bright Man! There are two types of enemies in this stage that you should keep your eyes peeled for. One looks like a giant light, and one is a firework dispenser. If you shoot the one that looks like a light, the stage darkens. However, if you fall into a hole and die, then things just work out fan-frickin-tastic, don't they? If you shoot the firework enemies, the stage lights back up, making everyone nice and happy again. So try to avoid killing the light enemies when it's not necessary, unless there is a firework enemy in the near vicinity, otherwise you won't be able to see certain things. There are also totem pole enemies. That's just crap. The totem poles make it difficult to advance in these areas with lots of spikes. However, these grasshoppers are so happy to help Mega Man in his quest! There's health in the top right path if you really want it. I don't need it yet. you take the lower path, you can get a 1-up in an E-tank. You have two ways you can do this. You can either ride these little elevators and just keep jumping over and over, getting you this nice happy E-tank and 1-up. Or you can do this the manly way. Fly. Ha ha ha. Who's gonna stop me? No one, that's who. Cause I'm Mega Man. Awesome. Help me, cricket thingy. We must save the world. Mega Man. Death to the totem pole. Thanks for the lift. Whee. Going up. Need some weapon energy, you can get a refill there, but who needs it? More enemies. Also, a nice little tidbit of knowledge, shooting one of the flashlight enemies doesn't make these elevators disappear. So you can kill one of them by accident in this area where there's no ground, and you're kinda okay. But where's the fun in that? There's no challenge. At the end of the level, we must face Bright Man, master of all things bright. He's not too hard. However, similar to an older model of Dr. Wily's robots, Flash Man, Bright Man is able to stop time. And when he stops time, you're at his mercy for a while. However, he doesn't do it very often. Ow. He wanted a hug. Oh, you jerk. Fine. If you're gonna be like that, you're just going to be like that! Well, la-di-da. Upon beating Bright Man, you acquire his weapon, the Flash Stopper! Even looks a lot like Flash Man's ability. Next time!